Today's mission, train AI agents in hand combat. Sounds cool? It is. But it comes at a cost of the possible extinction of humanity, and of course, at the cost of my graphics card. Ladies and gentlemen, the simulation is waiting for us. So let's take a closer look, shall we? 6'5", 95 kilos, our AI ragdoll is an absolute beast. Boasting 22 articulated joints, our ragdoll is designed to perfectly mimic the human body. But a ragdoll without a brain is merely a corpse. So let's give it a brain, and let's call the brain a neural network. Funny how humans decided to mimicry the most complex object in the whole universe, the human brain. In today's hand combat simulation, we are using a standard neural network architecture for our agents, consisting of 3 hidden layers, 1024 units each. In order to train this neural network, we are using a reinforcement learning algorithm called proximal policy optimization. This algorithm utilizes rewards and penalties to guide an agent's behavior. But a brain needs to be fed. Any intelligent entity needs to be able to observe its environment. . 299 observations will be fed to our agent's neural network. The agent can observe its 22 joints, including their positions, rotations, and angular velocities. This gives the agent a basic sense of self-awareness. But in a hand combat scenario, self-awareness is barely enough. The agent needs to be able to observe its opponent. Alongside self-awareness metrics, the relative distances to all of the opponent's limbs are also fed into our agent's neural network. This should give our agent complete sense of its environment, at least in theory. Observations are inputs to a neural network. Actions are outputs. A total of 63 actions will be produced by our agent in the form of limb and joint control, and hopefully, locomotion. A reinforcement learning algorithm demands rewards. Proper rewards result in proper behavior, and the desired behavior we are looking for is punching. Every time the agent lands a successful punch, we extract the magnitude of the punch's velocity. This magnitude is added over the course of the fighting round and results in a single variable called cumulative punch velocity. At the end of the round, the agent with higher cumulative punch velocity is considered the winner. This rewarding mechanism over the course of the training should result in competitive behavior. Collisions with the abdomen, chest, and head is considered a punch. Hitting the arms is considered blocking. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now ready for our first training session. See you on the other side. Thank you. Despite training our agent for millions of steps, it failed to learn any meaningful behavior. Was our simulation faulty? Maybe our rewarding mechanism was wrong, or perhaps the observations we fed into our neural network were not suffice. All these are possible explanations, but perhaps the most evident reason can be found by observing the training itself. Whether punches are being thrown or not is irrelevant, because even if they are, it's short-lived. The agent simply fails to maintain a strong footing on the ground, a severe lack in balance. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing transfer learning. We are now going to break up our training into sessions, balance and fighting. The brain model trained using balance will be transferred to fighting. This approach will make sure that our agents learn to balance first and punch later. But we are not going easy this time around. Alongside our standard reinforcement learning algorithm PPO, we are also going to be using the new smart kid in the class, Gale, and behavioral cloning, two state-of-the-art imitation learning algorithms. As evident by its name, imitation learning algorithms teach an AI to mimic certain behavior. For our balance training session, we are going to be feeding the imitation learning algorithm this motion capture footage, or in machine learning terms, a demonstration file. But there's a problem. While the agent will learn to imitate this demonstration's behavior and earn imitation learning rewards over time, it won't necessarily understand that falling over is bad and standing is good. The AI will simply try to copy the demonstration's movements. To fix this, we combine imitation with reinforcement learning. Alongside imitation learning, we will also place a dummy fighter into the scene and reward our agent for facing the dummy and staying close to it. And here's the twist: to make balancing harder and to allow our AI to generalize outside of the demonstration's movements, we will apply a random kick force to our agent's hips. This way, we will be training a robust balancing agent. Our balance training session is now ready. Good luck. Our training was a success. We now have a robust agent capable of balancing itself with ease. These are the training statistics. These four graphs are almost identical. They showcase the distance between our agent's limbs and the dummy's. Our agent was rewarded for facing and staying close to the dummy, and that's precisely what it did. Both the rewards and episode length increased over time, meaning our agent became better and better at balancing itself and remaining alive. Now it's time to throw some punches. For our second training phase of fighting, we will use the same method and setup as our first failed training attempt, except this time, instead of training from scratch, we will use our already trained model of balancing. We will also use this motion capture footage as our demonstration. This should help our agent learn to punch properly. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to throw some punches.
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.